So just coincidence, I have a device need to repair. It is a Wi-Fi problem, iPhone XR. So this iPhone XR, he got the Wi-Fi issue. Cannot be turned on. Okay. So I go to setting about, and then I see the Wi-Fi address is there, but it cannot be turned on. Okay, somehow it failed to work. So I'm gonna do repair this. After I change the Wi-Fi IC, I will use the P12 to unbind the Wi-Fi and keep the customer data, okay? But we are not sure whether it's a Wi-Fi IC problem or not, okay? I will check it. So whatever we do, we gonna to test the current before we proceed, okay? I will connect the power supply and then give him the power to see. Okay, there's no leading, and then press the power button. So first jump, okay, mean there's nothing half shot or something. So remove the shield.
Weapons activated.
So open the shield to see the Wi-Fi surrounding. Okay, the Wi-Fi is below the CPU, behind the NAND. Okay, so and then look at the surrounding. Okay, I already prepared the IC. Let's directly to change it, okay, without any measurement. And let's hope that it's just an IC problem. After I change, it still doesn't work. I need to measure the resistance and a lot of procedure, okay?
Weapons activated.
Okay. Okay, warm up complete. Now to remove it, be careful on CPU area and the tri-star here, they will be easily overheated. Okay, so okay, this is a good melting point. Most of the pack are still flat. Okay, if you didn't get this kind of symptoms, the packs is not flat like this, it means you are overheating. Okay, your temperature control is not okay. All my students in semester 1, they already know how to do this. Okay, I already explained how to get to perfect melting point when removing the IC. So they won't ask how much Celsius you use. No need to ask for temperature setting. So I won't do any measurement, I will just replace another Wi-Fi IC, okay? Okay, for sure the Wi-Fi won't be working because we need to unlock the Wi-Fi from the hard disk. But at least in this point, I'm going to turn on and test, okay, to make sure everything can turn on before I remove the hard disk. Okay, so this is the thing that we change. Wi-Fi won't be working for sure. There's still one more step. Unlock the Wi-Fi from the hard disk. Okay, this one. So this is the place that we are gonna use the MiJing P12. Okay, I will check the current before I continue. So jumping, okay. Then proceed to connect the battery and turn on the device and see. Okay, for sure Wi-Fi cannot be turned on, okay? is impossible. This is why they have a NAND tool to unbind the Wi-Fi. So now we look at it, Wi-Fi address is there, and then yeah. Okay. So continue unbind the Wi-Fi from the tools. Why we need put the flux? Because we want to look at the boiling point. Okay, the flux will react if the boiling point is reached, especially the melt point of the pack. So see boiling, the pack is melted. Okay. This is the empty pack, don't worry about it. Blue dot. Okay. So the temperature is still on perfect condition, okay? They are flat, mean only the top side melted, behind is not. Have a clean here first. Okay, it's done. So if you worry about this dot, you can take a look in the ZXW. Let's say in ZXW 10R, you will notice there's a blue dot. Okay, exactly there. Okay. Blue dot is mean empty, nothing. You can't click on it, okay? Okay, now continue to unbind the Wi-Fi from the hard disk, okay? But I need to clean up before I put into the tools, okay? Please do not put on the tools, the programming tools, without cleaning the flux, you know, okay? You must clean the flux, or else you might get the programming tools damage. That's it for this point, and now I show you. Okay, first I'm gonna tell you the MiJing P12 is using the Type C connection. Okay, and the other port is for the purple screen. Okay, to let you put the other device, the older model that support purple mode, and then you just plug in. Okay, so he's really clear to say. This is A1, mean the pin of the first in here. So you're gonna look at the NAND, where is your first pin. So you see this dot is mean the first pin. Or either look at the front, there's a dot here, okay? This is the first pin. As I say, before you put on it, you need to clean it, okay? You're gonna take care of your tools, okay? You need to clean it. There's no flux on the IC, and then you put on it. Okay. So first pin is here, just like this. Okay. So I'm not gonna do insert now. So go to programming tools. I just close this thing. Index the NAND chip fail. He detected this is 128 giga, okay, that's format and things like this, you know. Okay, all I need to do is Wi-Fi unlock. Okay, but before that I should back up first. Okay, the whole configuration, the serial number, everything, okay, save it aside. So you can see in here I have a backup. Okay, so if you click on it, you can see this is the 10R that I'm repairing. Okay, so what I need to do is just to unbind the Wi-Fi unlock, so then I can use the other Wi-Fi chip. Okay, click this and click the program. It seems the software is a bit confusing. The interface is not that friendly. They need to improve it. The software is not that friendly, but the speed is okay. Okay, 1 minute and 15 seconds. Okay, 75 seconds. I guess that's it. And then I start to reboot and install back. Okay. Right, so that's the current before you turn on. Okay. So now I'm gonna test whether he really can keep the data and unbind the Wi-Fi. Okay. So here we go. Yeah, baby. The Wi-Fi really can be turned on now. Okay. So he really can keep the data. Okay. The iOS still the same. Okay. Without need to restore, erase the phone. Okay. Okay, so Wi-Fi can be connected, no problem. Okay. I know it's Chinese, but you can understand it. Okay. So this is how the repair. I guess this will be all, and see you on the next video. Bye.